If you use headphones, you know that eventually you're going to lose sound in one or the other of the sides. This set of Sony headphones I've had for many, many years, and I've already had this happen once. I lost sound in the left side, and I repaired it, and now, a couple years after that one, I've lost sound in the right side. So it's a really easy repair for most types of headphones. The hardest part is getting in there. But there's actually two possible places where 90% of the time you'll run into the problem. Either the wire is going to break there, like within the first inch or two of where it goes into the headphone, or it's going to break in the same spot on the connector end within an inch or two of there, because that's where it gets the most flexing and against a hard edge. I've already checked, and I can tell that it is in fact an open circuit. So if I go on the between the common or the sleeve and the tip, which is the left side, you can see that there's about 70-ish ohms. But if I go on the ring or the right side, it's complete open circuit. So. But I already knew that. That tells me it's not a short, which it almost never is. Everybody says, oh, something's broken, it's probably a short. Very, very seldom. Usually it's an open circuit, a broken wire. And that, in this case, I'm pretty confident what it is. When I was listening to music, when it conked out, I gave this a wiggle and I could hear it cutting in and out as I was wiggling that end. And I heard nothing happen when I was wiggling this end. I'm pretty confident it's not this guy. So, the trick is to get into her, and that's always, every single type of headphones, every different brand is different, but pulling the ear cup, the pad off is usually a good place to start. This one is really tight, but it's, they don't want to shred it, obviously, because I want this to go back together. But this one, it's just a cuff that goes into this slot, this groove all the way around here. And then, it gets easy, because we've got two screw holes here. In this case, Phillips. And out she comes. There's the two screws. Now then, the strain relief, which is what prevents this wire from pulling out, is super duper simple. It's just a knot on the inside of the hole. So, since I know that it's already broken somewhere within the first inch there, what I'm going to do is even these two ends up, because I had to cut a chunk off the other one the last time, so I'll cut the same amount off this end. Even them up, so I'm going to want my strain relief to go there, and in this case I'm going to replace the simple knot with an equally simple zip strap. Can't be giving them an advertisement here. In that same position, just because it's easy, it'll let me mark the spot, and then I can pull that all the way through, so I can push that out of the way and actually be able to work on it. So, snip it off close, and so that was about that far from the strain relief. So I'll go about that far from the strain relief and then add a little bit. Hopefully that should get me inside of where it was broken off before. Now then, headphone wire is notoriously hard to deal with. Let's just zoom in on this and take a peek here. So there's the two wires. They're twisted. They're multi-strand wire. It's enameled. Each strand is enameled, which means It's got basically a varnish on it to act as the insulation so they don't splash against each other. And then for extra flexibility, it's got a little cotton or nylon or something kind of thread up the middle. And it doesn't solder very easily at all. It's super flexible. The more strand or the finer the strands, the more flexible it is, the more strands, the better conductor it is, the more power it can handle, and the more breakage it can tolerate before it finally breaks. But it does break. I have to basically strip it back without damaging that wire. And I'm going to do that just by gently rolling and nicking the outer rubber a little bit. Pull that off, and I went too far and I nicked it. So I'm gonna do it again, but more carefully, paying attention to what I'm doing this time. And there you see I've got a come on, zoom. See, I've got a weak spot in the outer rubber, but I haven't gotten into the middle yet. I'll just get my fingernail and pull it. And there I've got the two conductors. You've got the two conductors kind of stuck together. There we go. So now all I have to do is solder them back onto there in the right spots. Note that there is two very subtly different colors, or at least to my eyes they're subtly different, but I can see that they go like that. I'm just going to get in there with my soldering iron, pull one off at a time. Excuse me, I'm going to zoom out a little bit so that I can see what I'm doing here and get into a physical position. So I'll get some solder. Why won't that stay where I want it to be? Put some weight on it. Yeah. So in tinning this, I'm also going to melt off or burn off some of that enamel or whatever plastic coating happens to be on there to insulate it. And then I'll just gently retin that pad. And just tack it back on there. Okay, and repeat for the other guy. There it is. All right. Now then, let's just verify that this worked. So again, there's the tip, which is the other side, 70 ohms, and the ring, which is this side, 69.7 ohms. Awesome. And then, of course, the ultimate test. And the other side still works. There we go. Ta-da! Okay, now we just got to put it back together. Which is completely, okay, let's trim this tie wrap first using my flush cutters so I don't leave a sharp, ugly edge on there. I talked about that in a previous video when I got these, when I opened these ones. You don't want to use side cutters. You want to use flush cutters, just so you don't leave a sharp edge and don't cut yourself on it or cause other damage. And just a matter of getting this into here. What am I lining up? Trying to line up a bunch of different things. Oh, does that go the other way? It does. Okay, thank you, Sony. A whole bunch of... What? Trying to get those posts and those screw holes to line up. Oh, right. Yeah. Which way does that go? Goes to the back there. That does go this way. Okay. So just getting everything to line up. That's right. It doesn't sit tight and flush because you need that groove for the pad to sit in. I knew that. Come on, screw. This is literally the hardest part, getting the covers on and off. And really, that's not that big a challenge either. So there's that, and I'm stretching these buggers on. I remember I had a hard time with it before. It's just one of those things that you need three hands for. I'm not going to torture you by watching me do this. But a quick jump cut and it'll be all done. And there we are. It's back together. Let's just make sure it still works. Here's the left side. Here's the right side. Yay, how hard was that? Don't throw away your headphones if they're broken. You can fix them. It's easy. That's it. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later.